My name is Laura Jesse Iles. I run the Plant and Insect Diagnostic Clinic here at Iowa State University, and today I'm going to show you how to do tick dragging. So ticks, and we have three common ticks in Iowa: the Lone Star tick, the black-legged tick, also called the deer tick, and the American dog tick. So those are our three common hard-bodied ticks which we would be outdoor sampling for. Common tick habitat is wooded areas and then areas with good undergrowth, so either kind of tall grass near trees or lots of brushy undergrowth, because ticks don't fall down from trees, they can't fly, they can't jump. They're down in those low-growing plants, and when you walk by, that's when they grab onto you. And of course, they're there because most of their other hosts, the mice, the deer, and other small mammals and birds are there as well. So those are the areas we want to sample when we're doing some sort of tick sampling. So before we start, and before you kind of, you know, get all ready and we'll go through supplies and things, you want to think about the goals of your sampling. So do you just want to know yes, no? Is there ticks here, yes or no? So that's a pretty simple question. Or are you looking to count the number of ticks there? Some reasons you might want to count the number of ticks are you're comparing different areas, or you're planning to do some sort of management, so you want to count the number of ticks before you do your management, and then the number of ticks after you do your management. Are you here, is this your own backyard? Is this a park area and you've received complaints from people about tick activity? So think about kind of why you're there, why you're sampling, and what your goals of the sampling are before you start, because that'll depend a little bit on what sort of supplies you need and what sort of sampling to do. So now we'll go over the basic supplies needed and how to put together a basic tick drag. Okay, so tick dragging is fairly simple. We're going to just, at the end, we will have this basic piece of white material attached to something with a handle that you can drag basically through the undergrowth or other areas. So I'll show you how to make this. Other things that you're going to want to have are either some sort of, you know, Tyvek or protective coverall. This is in part because you're sampling as well, so nice white will help so you can pull the ticks off yourself. If you don't have access to that, I would recommend, you know, light colored clothing, and definitely want to tuck pant legs into socks. It also helps prevent you from getting ticks yourself while you're doing this. You'll have some sort of pole. I just got some PVC from the local hardware store. I just got some cloth as well. You know, the kind of cloth, you don't want something really smooth that the ticks can't grab onto. What I purchased is actually a little thin. I'd probably go a little thicker. It depends. If I was going through really wooded areas, this would probably get snagged up pretty quickly. So some sort of light or white color cloth. I mean, I think if you have a sheet that's, you know, light colored, you can just chop that up as well into about, you know, a yard by a yard. Some sort of rope for a handle, scissors, and then this is where you're sampling things. So something to label, a permanent marker, tweezers of some sort to gather up ticks. I get special insect tweezers, but pretty much any tweezers will do. And then some sort of vials or containers to put your ticks in. And these are pretty easy to get online. You can just search vials and buy whole boxes of them if you want. You're gonna want to kill the ticks pretty quickly. You don't want them crawling in and out. I prefer hand sanitizer just because hand sanitizer contains a lot of alcohol, so it's a good preservative, but it's also a bit viscous, so when you accidentally drop your little vial, the things don't immediately come out, so you can just add bits of hand sanitizer to your vial, like so. And as you can see, if you had your ticks in it and you tip it, nothing moves very quickly, so that's why I like hand sanitizer. It's forgiving of my clumsiness. And you want to label things, you know, before you get sampling, just because I find, like, once you've gotten into the suit and you're out sampling, you're going to be sweaty, you're going to be tired. That's you have a real tendency to toss things into the car and leave. So at that point, you want to label with something that, you know, means something to you, whether it's an address or a park name, and the date. Do you just dash that on there with the year, and you're pretty much set to go. You can obviously put ticks into, you know, baggies, sandwich bags, things like that. The problem is it's pretty easier for them to climb out, so you don't be repeatedly putting them in and out. So now I'll show you how to make the actual tick drag. I have your material, and I just basically purchased 2 yards of material, which would make about four of them, because on the bolt of material, it's folded in half. It's actually the first time I've ever purchased material, so I didn't know that. You just want to cut them roughly into squares, and if there's anyone in the audience who actually ever does sewing, you're going to be pained right now at my cutting techniques. Again, we're dragging in the woods for ticks so that ticks aren't too picky about what we're doing here. So you've got your piece of material. How you attach it to your pole is up to you. I mean, obviously you could pretty easily just fold over, sew it, and then, you know, just run your pole into it. I don't know how to sew, so I use duct tape. There we go. So basically it's now attached to our pole. I kind of put a couple of little pieces on the edge so the cloth doesn't bunch up too much. So something like that, just fine. You'll probably want to replace the cloth pretty regularly as it gets snagged up or dirty. Remember, I would probably put, if you're done for the day, fold it up and put it in a Ziploc bag or something in your vehicle. You definitely don't want to miss a tick on it and then have it climb off into your vehicle or into your house. And if you're moving between different sampling sites, you can, you know, just replace it and grab a new cloth. The handle can be pretty much anything. I just grabbed some rope at the store. You just kind of run it in. So it comes out the other side. And then you just run it through. You want to loop it enough so you can kind of walk comfortably without stooping over, and probably avoid what I just did, which is get your rope in a big, huge, giant knot. I don't do any sort of fancy knot. I just tie it. Doesn't have to be that rough. And there you've got your handle and your tick drag. So at this point, you want to gather up your vials, you know, a plastic bag to put them in if you want. If you're gonna have multiple vials, always helps to me to always have some plastic bags around. Get into your Tyvek suit. If you don't have a Tyvek suit, be sure to be wearing light colored clothing and tuck those pant legs into your socks. So next we'll show actually how you would go do some dragging. In my suit, my tick drag, my vial, and my tweezers. And when we go into the habitat that we're going to sample, in this case, I'm not wanting to make comparisons like, you know, before treatment or after treatment or different parks or different yards. So I'm just going to kind of randomly move through it. If you're wanting to do kind of a before treatment, after treatment, you want to be careful to, you know, do, you know, 20 paces or, you know, 50 paces or, you know, 20 paces here and 20 paces there. Like, you want to do something that you know you're keeping your how much area you're sampling pretty even. And then we're just gonna move in and I'll show you how to drag the cloth through the material and hopefully we'll get some ticks. Okay, here we are in a great place to sample along a path here in a park. So these are areas where ticks are likely. If this is a case where you've, you know, received complaints or concerns about ticks, you might want to do a count, or if you're wanting to see if tick populations change over time. So in this case, we're going to kind of count out 50 paces as we drag our cloth along. For the most part, you can kind of use the handle. Then I kind of grab on to the pole to hold it tight when I need to. 3, 4, 5, 6, 47, 48, 49, 50. Okay, you've walked 50 paces and you want to check and see if you've gotten anything. See, well, it looks like we've gotten a little bit of plant material. You don't see any ticks, and you want to look closely. Obviously, this time of year is in the fall, so adults are more likely, but larval and nymphal ticks would be very small. And then you also want to check the top side of your cloth as well. Yeah. Again, to remove ticks, you just grasp them firmly with the tweezers and pull them off. Don't put anything on them or things like that. So be sure to check yourself as soon as you get home. You might consider removing the clothing that you were wearing and just putting it, you know, in a container or something like that, or just laundering it directly so that you don't risk ticks crawling around in your house. And I remember being a kid and the school nurse coming after me with the, you know, the matchstick kind of thing. So there's lots of these kind of methods to get the tick to let go or back out, even people who kind of like twist the tick to try to untwist it. All of these things won't do any good, and they're likely to irritate the tick and make possibly it more likely to regurgitate in you and transmit disease. So it actually not only doesn't help, it actually adds to the risk that you're going to catch some disease. Lyme disease is obviously something we're very concerned of with black-legged tick, but there's other diseases out there. So that's why we don't want to irritate the tick, we just want to yank it out. There's always kind of the fear of the mouth parts or the head getting left in, and obviously that's not, you know, pleasant, but it's just a foreign body in your skin. And once the tick's out, you want to just, you know, clean that area. And if, you know, you left part of the mouth parts of the head in, you can get in touch with your physician, but that part isn't as dangerous as the disease transmission.